Hello, 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 and welcome to Tux Take, brought to you by the best in the business, PlaySugarHouse.com. Let's see if we can keep that cannoli rolling. What does that mean? I don't know. While Green Bay has obviously been disappointing, the crazy thing is, of the five games left on their schedule, four of them, very winnable. Could Green Bay actually turn things around? It all starts this week with a gimme win versus Arizona. Question isn't really whether they win or not, it's just a matter of spread. By the way, if they lose, McCarthy is fired on Monday. The total is only 44, and yet Green Bay is laying two touchdowns. That's a lot of points in a relatively low-scoring game. This is another game where I might just watch the game and browse the PlaySugarHouse.com site looking for live in-game betting opportunities. If you must bet this game, I'm on the under and Green Bay. The exciting Lamar Jackson is slated to start his third straight game for the Ravens as they take on the Falcons in Atlanta. From a fantasy perspective, Jackson is only getting better, and this week, he should eat. Yum, 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 yum. Atlanta's defense is ill-equipped to deal with the dual threat of Lamar Jackson running and throwing. Can the Falcons' offense keep up? That's the question. They hit a bump in the road the last couple of games, and as I mentioned a few weeks ago, this offense needs to be perfect for the Falcons to win. The Ravens' defense is too good to be perfect against. The play here? Baltimore. Nothing says Week 13 like a meaningless Buffalo Bills-Miami Dolphins game. Fortunately, at PlaySugarHouse.com, no game is meaningless. In all fairness, Buffalo fans are excited to see Josh Allen back healthy. He needs all the experience he can get. And of course, fans in the Sunshine State are happy, I think, to see Ryan Tannehill back. Speaking of Tanny, what does Miami do with him? I mean, they don't have any better options, but he doesn't seem like the answer. I mean, at this point, I don't even know what the question is anymore. From a betting perspective, this game is something I'm interested in. Buffalo is playing hard. Their defense is better than people thought it would be, and Josh Allen is absolutely fearless. Dude is crazy. That alone might keep them in the game. Miami is the better team, but are they 5 points better? I think it's close. But at home, give me the Fins. Carolina burned me last week. In a must-win game at home, they had a halftime lead, a lead at the end of the third quarter, and a 7-point lead with 4 minutes to play, only to lose. At home. Now they go on the road where they struggled all season long. If there's a silver lining, it's that they travel to Tampa Bay, who they already beat by 14 this year. Jameis Winston looks like he's back. Of course, that is until he's not. This quarterback situation in Tampa is clearly untenable. I understand why they stuck with Fitzpatrick after he started the season on fire, but the back and forth and back and forth and back and forth, it's just unsettling for a team. It's unsettling for me. Now, if Carolina has any playoff aspirations, this is an absolute must-win. And to be honest, I'm not sure they can do it on the road. The last time these two played, a ton of points were scored. And last week for Seattle, a ton of points were scored. You see where I'm going? I think the trend continues. The play here is the over. What makes Indianapolis more dangerous this year than in years past is their defense and their offensive line. Well, obviously, Andrew Luck being healthy helps too. Rookie linebacker Darius Leonard flies around the field on a weekly basis, and left tackle Anthony Costanzo and rookie left guard Quentin Nelson rarely allow anyone to hit Andrew Luck. Now in Jacksonville, the wheels are officially off the track. Offensive coordinator Nathaniel Hackett has been fired, and the Blake Bortles experiment appears to finally be over. Cody Kessler takes over under center. Don't get too excited, Jacksonville fans. Kessler hasn't started a game since 2016, and he went 0-8 that year. Now, could the Jaguars respond this Sunday? I suppose anything's possible. But at this point, are you willing to put your money on it? Are you willing to put anybody's money on it? My money? Whose money? I'll take the team that's won 5 straight and has a quarterback in Andrew Luck who has thrown at least 3 touchdown passes in 8 straight games. Coming off a loss and a bye, most well-coached teams respond positively. I expect that trend to continue when the Rams face off against the Lions. The LA Rams defense is far from perfect, but they are opportunistic. Enter stage left Matthew Stafford, whose season has been marred by inconsistencies, except for the fact he's consistently putting the ball in harm's way. When it's all said and done, I expect Los Angeles to score plenty on offense and possibly defense. Give me the Rams and the over in the Double Dipper Special of the Week. The Chicago Bears are on quite a roll. How about them Bears, huh? 5 straight wins and a good shot at the NFC North crown. keep in mind of the five wins, one was the Jets, one was Buffalo, two were Detroit. But that's not the Bears' fault. They can only play who's on the schedule. And this week, they get the New York Giants, the G-men. The G-men have struggled mightily for most of the season, but they've shown some life the past few weeks. But this is a tough matchup for them. It almost seems weird to talk about a defense dominating an offense in 2018, but that's exactly what I expect to see. In fact, I think the awkward conversation following this game might be the "do we bench Eli" chat. Chicago wins this one going away, 27-6. The Browns are 4-6-1, which might not sound like that big an accomplishment until you realize they've already accumulated the same number of wins they had in the past three seasons combined. Yeah, it's been that bad. Rookie quarterback Baker Mayfield is a big part of the turnaround, but he's not the only reason. A young and talented defense led by another former number one pick overall, Myles Garrett, has made their mark. Garrett has a ton of room to grow as he blossoms into one of the best pass rushers in the league. In the meantime, he's improving as a run defender and on pace for 16 sacks. This week, they play against the Houston Texans, the same Texans team that started the season off 0-3, only to reel off 8 straight wins. This is an underrated game that I've got circled on my calendar. Lots of young talent on both teams and on both sides of the ball. While it wouldn't shock me if J.J. Watt ruined Cleveland's day, and in turn my day, my money is nonetheless going on the dog. Cleveland is 7-4 against the spread this year, and Houston is playing on a short week. Take the points and the brownies. Another game that almost looks too good to be true when Denver plays Cincinnati. Coming off two huge wins, you'd think that maybe Denver has a letdown game, but they're back in the playoff conversation, and they know they cannot afford a misstep. Wait, why am I spending this much time on this game? Marvin Lewis and Hugh Jackson are still coaching the Bengals, right? Oh, okay. And while Andy Dalton was playing some bad football, he's certainly better than backup quarterback Jeff Driscoll. Jeff Driscoll. Von Miller must be licking his lips. Denver's the play. Don't overthink this one. Happy Sunday, everyone. Happy Sunday. Enjoy the games, and good luck.